Today we'll be discussing about PIC microcontrollers. So we have already studied about 805 microcontrollers. We studied about its different features and how we can interface that microcontroller. Now we are going to venture into a new type of microcontroller, and which is very popular in the market, which is called as PIC, PIC. So let's see, what is PIC microcontroller? PIC basically is abbreviated as Peripheral Interface Controller. It was developed by Microchip Technology, and it is one of the most popular microcontrollers that you find in the 8-bit microcontroller market today. One reason that it is most popular is because it is not only the it can be not only programmed in assembly language program, but it can also be programmed using C program. There are C compilers available for PIC microcontroller, which makes it very easy for a developer to program it for any application, whether it is a household application, whether it is a project for a student, or even if it is a commercial application. Anybody can realize an application just by using a simple C code. So it is also available in different packages as per the need. So it is available in a 40-pin dual inline package, or it is available in a 44-pin surface mounted package, mostly used in commercial and industry product. And is also available in a more application-oriented package of 28-pin and 18-pin variants. 28-pin and 18-pin variants houses a little lesser ports and features compared to the 40 and the 44-pin. As you can see, 20-pin part houses lesser port pins, 11 lesser port pins than the 40 and the 44-pin surface-mounted versions of PIC microcontroller. The 18 pin part has very reduced functionality level itself, which is very much most of the timer and serial expansion facility is chopped off, which makes it a very application oriented, a simple application oriented chip, the 18 pin part one. So your PIC microcontroller is actually a family of microcontrollers. There are various microcontrollers out there in the market which vary according to their memory size, their RAM size, their ROM size, which vary according to their port size, which vary according to the functionality levels. So that gives it different names, like PIC16C74A is what we'll be learning in detail, but there are many other family of microcontrollers of PIC available there in the market. So let's see in detail what makes PIC so popular. So some of the factors, as you can see listed down over here, are what makes PIC microcontrollers very popular. Let's see them in detail. What are these factors? So the speed is one very important factor which makes PIC microcontroller very popular. As you can see, it hardly takes 0.2 microsecond at maximum clock rate to execute one instruction. Now that means it can execute up to 5 instructions per microsecond. Now that is way beyond the capability of most of the microcontrollers available there in the market. This makes PIC microcontroller very useful for high speed instruction execution. So speed is one reason why PIC microcontrollers are very popular out there in the market. The other reason is its instruction set simplicity. Now you know a lot number of microcontrollers or processors come with a very complex instruction set, with many number of instructions which you need to refer and program. But with PIC microcontroller, there's hardly 35 instructions which are very easy to understand and write a program with. That makes it quite popular. Integration of some operational features such as power on reset and also brownout protection. Brownout protection is to ensure that your microcontroller always operate within the given power range. Because if the microcontroller do not operate within the given power range, the microcontroller can be damaged. So whenever it does not operate within the given power range, the microcontroller can reset or reboot or even shut down. So such features are available in your PIC microcontroller. There's another feature called watchdog timer. Watchdog timer intimates your microcontroller of any program malfunction. It automatically resets the program in the microcontroller. So this makes this microcontroller quite popular. And it has a variety of low power options, so that it can be used in a variety of application level interfaces. And then it has options of different types of oscillators that's low cost RC oscillator as well as it can you can use. It's also compatible with a very high cost but stable crystal oscillator circuits also. So these are some of the integration operation features which gives you a lot of flexibility using PIC microcontrollers. As you know, to count an event or to generate a delay or to count an external event, you need timer options in a microcontroller, and on board with PIC you have three timers and it can be programmed with varying speed. So there are three timers available. Three timers available. There is an interrupt control logic available. There are of course up to 12 interrupt controls, which gives you a lot of flexibility in executing a subroutine for your program. And your output pins of your PIC, that is your port pins of your PIC microcontroller, comes with a good load bearing capability. It gives it can drive a load up to 25 milliampere, which is quite good compared to other microcontrollers in the market, which makes it quite a popular choice. Input-output port expansion is achievable by using serial peripheral interface or I2C interface, which gives you additional feasibility of connecting an input or output device with your microcontroller. Serial programming can be done for microcontroller. You can program your microcontroller just by using two pins. That's how simple it is to program a PIC microcontroller. And it is available in various ways, various chips or semiconductor devices. It is available as electrically erasable, ultraviolet erasable ROM memory, or it is also available as a one-time programmable memory unit, which makes PIC microcontroller very popular in the market, because a developer, like a student for doing a project, can use a ultraviolet erasable programmable PIC, in which he can write a program and execute an application and rewrite and rewrite a program. But at the same time, a commercial product or an industrial a person who is making a product and launching in the market may require a microcontroller which may be just programmed once. In fact, the microcontroller, one-time programmable microcontrollers, are much more cheaper than the reprogrammable ones. So the variance or the variety of microcontroller, that is to either we can reprogram it or program it once, that is OTP or one-time programmable ones, are available with PIC microcontrollers, which makes it quite feasible. The variety of people, the people who use it, whether it is a student or an industrial person who's launched a product, both of them can use it with a lot of ease. This makes this microcontroller quite popular. Now, the support for this microcontroller is very much available online, and also the simulators and the assemblers of this microcontrollers are free of cost. These all things are made so that the microcontroller remains very popular and competitive in the microcontroller market in the present age. So that is, these are the reasons why the PIC microcontrollers are very popular in the market today, and I hope you'll also like to use one.